Hi and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. If you are new and you like makeup, beauty, hair or hauls, then please consider subscribing. So today I'm going to be doing a full face of first impressions. I went to a discount makeup store, which was the Cosmetics Company Shop, I think it is, which was in an outlet near me, Springfields Outlet in Spalding, if you know it, but it's a very small one. But anyway, I picked up some real gems. So I figured I'd put them into a first impressions video. I did do like a little TikTok showing them. If you follow me on there, I put it on there and also a reel as well on Instagram. Yeah, so I grabbed, I'll show you quickly, the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Bronzer. I normally use the standard chocolate bronzer, but yeah, I wanted to try this one because it's supposed to be really good as a contour because it's quite cool. So yeah, I picked this one up. This was $19.75 from them, but I grabbed that. I got the Bobbi Brown Brick Highlighter, which is in the shade Pink Glow, it says on there. I got the Little MAC 9-pan palette. This is I'm not sure, one of the collaborations that they do. I also got the Cruella Lipstick in the shade Sweet and Vicious. And then I grabbed the Too Faced. This is the newer brow detailer pencil. This was £14. This was £12.25. This should have been £19.75. And this should have been £26. But they had a deal on where you could choose any five for 60 quid. So I got all of that for 60 quid. And then I got the Too Faced, the little butterfly palette as well for 15 quid. So I'm going to do that in a separate video. I've also got the Miccilo foundation, which I did again do a short with, but I'm going to do this in a more detailed review on this video. And then I also have the new Beauty Bay quad face palette, which I have reviewed on its own. However, I didn't review this blush, I did this one, so I'm going to use this one today. And then I also have the new BPerfect Lockdown Translucent Powder as well, which I have actually used once already, but I haven't used it in a video, so I'm going to show you that today as well. So first up, I'm going to be going in with foundation. So as I say, it's the Miccilo foundation, so it's this one just here. And I've got the shade 104, which is buff beige. This, I think, is about £26, or you can get a set for about £34, a set of three. So that works out a lot more affordable. They are all different colours, mind. There's like a light set, a medium set, a dark set. So obviously depending on your skin tone. But what I figured was this is kind of like the middle shade that they did. And then there's a lighter foundation, which would be good for winter. And then there's also a darker one, which would be good for when I've got a tan. So yeah, perfect. So I'm going in with, as I say, 104. You get about that much from one pump. So I'm going to take two pumps. So it's about that. It is very full coverage. It actually reminds me, the consistency of this, of the BPerfect Chroma Cover. It's very, very similar in, you know, consistency and coverage. Right, so as you can see, that's where I have done it and that's where I haven't. So it's quite a difference. So I'll just go and put the rest on now. Okay, so we're looking at that, which I think's, you know, beautiful, beautiful coverage. I don't normally go for a really full coverage foundation, but you know, if I'm going out or for an event or something like that, this is great. So I'll just give you a little close up there of how that looks on my skin. And yeah, I think it's really nice. It's not too matte either. It's quite a nice kind of satin finish. So it's kind of like in between glowy and matte, I would say. So next we're going to go on with brows, and I picked up the Too Faced. This is the Superfine Brow Detailer, and I picked up the shade Taupe, which is kind of like a pale brown. I normally go for like taupe shades. So it looks like this, with a really cute heart on the end just there. And then we've got our, it's kind of like an oval. Can you see that? It's like an oval on the end there. And then there's a brush on the end as well. So I take both the lids off and then I just brush my brows quickly first. Like that. And then I'll just speed through this bit. That's a bit light. Oh, what a shame. Yeah, that's going to be too... It's just snapped. That's going to be too light for me. Oh, pants. Hey ho, you win some, you lose some. First time I've used it. If anyone wants it, they can have it. Yeah, first person to contact me who wants this, you're welcome to it. That's such a shame. But yeah, it looks really nice. What can I say? I'm going to have to go and do them with my usual products. So I'll be back in a minute. I went in with the She Glam, the 2-in-1 pen and pencil, which I use all the time, to be honest. And I can't remember what shade this is, but it's like, I think it's the light brown one, and the 24-hour brow setter from Benefit as well, which I've just dropped on the floor, so I can't show you that. I can't be bothered to pick it up. So next I'm going to go in with the eyeshadow palette. So how pretty is this packaging? Really, really nice. It doesn't say on it who the collaboration's with, strangely enough, but I'm sure it's a collaboration with an influencer or an MUA, something like that. But yeah, it's this one here. So it's the Made My Fortune eyeshadow palette from MAC. And then this is the colour story just here. So really pretty. Nice warm tones in this one. So I'd say this is a bit of an all year round one, really. I mean, yeah, all right. It's probably more for like winter, autumn, but you could get away with this all year round easily. I love this kind of pinky shimmer here. I'll give them a quick swatch. So this is what the swatches look like. These are really nice, really nice. I've never used MAC eyeshadows before, but I'm actually really, really impressed with the formula. Beautiful. Yeah, that pink's nice, isn't it? So I'm just going to start off by priming my lids, and I'm going to be using the BPerfect Perfect Prime, which is this one just here. I use this one all the time, to be honest with you. It's not a first impression. So I'm just going to whack this on. I've just realised I've completely forgotten to do powder. So I'm going to do that now before I do my eyes. Oh, I'm all over the place today. So as I say, it's the Lockdown Powder by BPerfect. So it's this one just here. So it looks white in the pan, but it is a translucent powder, as most of the white powders are. There you go, you can see that now. So yeah, I'm going to whack this on. I really like this. As I say, I've used it once before, but it's I don't normally use powders because I don't like the finish that you get. I don't like that kind of like mattified look that you get from powder. But this one is completely different, and it's really quite affordable. I think it was about $13.95. So I'm just gonna pop some onto a big brush just here and literally just pat it all over. But I don't know if it's got like some kind of luminous particles in it or something, but it actually gives like a glowy finish, which, you know, is what I go for anyway. And I actually really love the way it makes my skin look. There. So I'll just go down my neck a little bit. But yeah, really, really nice. I love the finish of it. Yeah, beautiful. This is one that's definitely going to work its way into like my everyday makeup routine. For someone that hasn't used powder in the past, because I don't like it, I do like this one. Right, so going back to the eyeshadow now. So it's this one here, as I say, and I'm going to go in with the shade. I think I'm going to start off with this one just here, just to set down my primer first. Pay particular attention to my crease because I that they crease, to be honest with you. So yeah, I kind of add more there. Yeah, just like that. Nice and easy, simple. Okay, lovely. So then what I'm going to do is go into my crease and the outer part of my lid here as well. I'm doing something fairly simple today because I always find on, you know, first impressions video, they're quite long anyway, so I try and keep the eyes fairly simple. So I'm going to go in with the darkest one, which is this one here in the corner. Really nice pigment on that. Really nice. Just like that. And then I'm going to use this shade just here, just to blend out those edges. So like that, which I think is actually really quite nice. And then on the inner part here, I'm going to go in with that pinky coloured shimmer that I like. So it's the bottom one, just there. Quite a bit of fallout when using a brush with that one, so I'm going in with my finger instead. Which, to be honest, you get a lot better colour pay off with your finger as well. Like that. So quite simple. I've kind of kept it on the lower part of my lid there. Yeah, it's pretty. It's really nice. Right, so underneath I'm going to take, I think I'm actually going to go in with this kind of rusty brown shade just here. Just like that. So I think that's really pretty, really nice, and it's all blended beautifully as well. So I'll just pop some mascara on. I don't have a new mascara, so I'm just going to go on with the Primark Billion Dollar Lashes mascara. I'm just going to whack that on. So for contour, I'm going to go in with the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil, or Soleil, whatever you want to say. I think it is Soleil, but I always say Soleil just to be different. So the packaging looks like this. And then this is the product itself. So it's very cool toned for a bronzer, which, you know, I do fine with them. The other one that's slightly darker is the same. So I'm just going to go in with an angled brush. Oh, it smells amazing. It actually smells like chocolate. And then I'm just going to apply this as a contour. See, it's a perfect contour shade. Can you see how cool toned that is? It's actually beautiful for a contour. And then I don't have a new bronzer. I'm just going to go in with my MAC Give Me Sun. So I'm just going to whack this on. Okay, so next for blush, I'm going in with the Beauty Bay Bronze Blush Glow Palette. And I'm going to, this is the light one. And I'm going to go in with the shade Rosebud. So it's this one just here. You see how pigmented that is? That's crazy. In a good way. Yeah, that's really nice. Gorgeous shade of pink. Beautiful. But very light-handed with it. It's I just can't express how pigmented it is, but it's good quality because a little bit goes a long way. And then for highlighter, I'm going to go in with the Bobbi Brown highlighter. This is the brick one. So it's this one just here. How stunning is that? Really, really nice. And then if I give it a little swatch for you, it's like that. So really, really pretty. Right then, I'm excited for this. I've never owned a Bobbi Brown product before, so this is my first time using one. And I'm excited. Right. Oh gosh, look at that. It literally melted into my skin like butter. Oh, that is so nice. Is that showing up? That is beautiful. Love that. Beautiful. Love it. Really, really nice. Probably one of the nicest highlighters that I've ever tried, actually. Really, really pleased with that. And then very lastly, we are going in with the MAC Cruella de Vil lipstick. So this one's in the shade Sweet and Vicious. There were three shades. I think there was a red one and possibly a more mauvey pink one. And I went for this kind of nudie pink shade just here. I've got such crusty lips at the moment. I hope it goes on all right. It's a really pretty colour, actually. Really nice. It's a lot paler than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be more like Velvet Teddy, something like that. So possibly like a shade or two darker. But it is a really pretty colour. Right then, so we're done. So I'm just going to sort out this inner corner of my eye and pop on some setting spray and then I'll be back. Okay, so here is the finished look. And yeah, I absolutely love it. Absolutely love it. I really do. The eyes went exactly to plan. You know, as I said, it was something quite simple because I was doing a lot today on film. But yeah, it was... It was nice. It went on really nicely. This corner of my eye, just ignore it because it's nothing to do with the product. It's just my hay fever. It does play up sometimes and it makes that corner water, which, yeah, isn't good when you do an eyeshadow. So pay more attention to this eye. But yeah, my base I absolutely love as well. I love this foundation. It is so nice. My favourite full coverage foundation is the BPerfect Chroma Cover, the one that I mentioned before. And this is a very, very close dupe to that, I would say. The contour or the bronzer that I use for the contour, perfect, the same as the blush. And I absolutely adore the highlighter. I think that is just stunning. I can't stop looking at that glow. It is a glow, isn't it? It's not like a stripe or anything. It just gives that really nice glow. Oh, I'm obsessed with it. Absolutely obsessed. I will be using this every day. So as always, any products that I've used in today's video, I will link in the description box below for you, along with any discount codes I can find, anything like that. Other than that, I hope you enjoyed watching. And if you did, please give me a thumbs up. And I'd really appreciate it. It'd mean the absolute world to me if you did enjoy watching this video and you would like to see more content from me in the future and you would like to subscribe to my channel. Until then, thanks for watching. Bye!
Me. Isn't it my birthday yet? Cause I gotta say, you're looking like a gift for me. Wrapped up nice and neat, baby.